Education Society, redefining excellence.
Hi everyone, we are G12 group, and for PBL project we have made a PowerPoint presentation. The past participants are Om Tibe, Shivendra Sutar, Nikhil Ulemale, Amay Sutar and Praveen Sutar. So let's see what Om Tibe has for us.
Thank you, Nikhil. So let's start. We have selected two objects. One is dish hanger and one is bulletproof jacket. So let's start with dish hanger. So for making dish hanger, two types of materials are used: stainless steel or plastic. There are two types of dish hangers: wall hanging type and stand type. So why stainless steel is used in a dish hanger? It is more durable and rust free, can carry more load compared to plastic dish hanger. Tensile strength is 621 megapascal. It is cheap compared to other materials. It is easy to clean, and it is available in both stand and wall hanging types. And why? And the plastic dish hangers are made with polyethylene. So why polyethylene? It is made up of high density. The dish hanger is made up of high density polyethylene, whose tensile strength is 23 to 29.5 megapascal. It is durable and rust free. Dish hanger of this material can be used for storing less amount of dishes and utensils compared to stainless steel dish hangers. It cannot be wall mount like stainless steel dish hangers because its tensile strength is very less compared to stainless steel, and thus it cannot bear the weight of the dishes. So the next slide, I would like to hand over to Shivendra Sutar.
Thank you, Om, for handing over this PPT to me. Hello, I'm Shivendra Sutar. Manufacturing processes, okay, we will see the manufacturing process of the stainless steel dish hanger. Manufactured by performing bending operations on the sheet metal and hollow stainless steel pipes. Then after bending operations, joining of the components takes place using nuts and bolts or by welding, especially electric welding or spot welding. Next slide. High density polyethylene, okay. Why we use high density polyethylene in a plastic dish hangers? Made by the injection molding and extrusion process, parts are made such that they fit into each other. Therefore, they can be easily assembled and disassembled. And there is no need of screw and welding. Our next topic is bulletproof vest. And the materials used in the bulletproof vest is ceramic, composite and Kevlar, okay. Now, from hereby, I will hand over this PPT to Praveen Sutar. Thank you.
Thanks, Shivendra. Myself, Praveen Sutar. I would like to explain what is the Kevlar material exactly. It is an extremely strong man-made fiber. It has tensile strength in the range of 3.6 to 4.1 GPa. It is 5 times stronger than steel nor usual steel. It is stronger at low temperature but weakened at high temperature. It is fire resistant, has high cut resistance. It also has lower electrical conductivity. It also has impact resistance and high chemical resistance. Next slide. Here is the diagram of the Kevlar material. So it has four layers. First layer consists of the film. Second and third layer consist of the fibers and resins at 0 and 90 degrees. And the fourth layer is also a film. So for further slide, I will like Nikhil to elaborate.
Thank you, Praveen. Manufacturing process of bulletproof jacket. First, pieces of Kevlar are cut off of huge Kevlar rolls. Then these pieces are stacked over each other so as to form a 25 to 40 layer Kevlar protection wall. Each layer is placed in 90 degree to previous layer. The exterior of the jacket is also made using Kevlar. Additional pockets are also created for carrying gun, magazines, and a big pocket is provided to insert a ceramic plate in front of protection from rifles. The ceramic plate is made by processing a ceramic composite, which is powder form, using a hydraulic press. The ceramic plate is easily pressable component in a vest and provides a high level of protection, which is called as level 3 protection. There is a YouTube link shared where we can see the detailed version of bulletproof jacket. The sources from which we have gathered all the information are Google, Wikipedia, and YouTube. Thank you.